What's good, y'all? In this video, we're going to talk about using algorithms to solve problems in computer science. Specifically, we're going to discuss features of good algorithms, how we write algorithms to solve problems. Let's jump right in and recall in a previous video, we actually wrote a MATLAB script file seen here on screen to solve quadratic equations by leveraging the quadratic formula. Remember, as we were writing this code, we used previous knowledge from our mathematical lives to inform the way that we wanted to write our code. As we become more sophisticated coders and problem solving using MATLAB, there will be times that before we write a single line of code, we want to be very, very clear on what approach we're going to use. To do that, one tool we can use is known as an algorithm. We can see right next to the code on the left-hand side, we actually have an algorithmic statement, a step-by-step analysis of the type of work we're going to accomplish with that code. Specifically, we could call this an algorithm to solve quadratic equations. The first part of this algorithm is going to be to store the different values of A, B, and C in the standard form of our quadratic equation. We see that in lines 1 through 3 of our code that accomplishes step 1. The next step of this algorithm is going to be to find the first root using the quadratic formula where we set x1 equal to negative b minus square root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. That is in line 5. Then we're going to go on and verify that that calculated solution actually solves our problem. In other words, we're going to check that x1 is a root to our standard quadratic function. That is done in line 6 of our actual code. Second to last thing we're going to do in this algorithm is to find the second root by changing the negative to a positive. This comes from the quadratic formula. And then the last thing we're going to do is check that the second root that we calculated actually solves our intended problem. On the left-hand side, we see our algorithmic statement for our solving the quadratic equation. On the bottom of the screen, we actually see the syntax that implements this algorithm. I want to call out some of the features of this algorithm that we are going to recreate as we write algorithms to solve other more complicated problems. The first feature we're going to shoot for when we're writing algorithms is we want to write a series of steps that ends before we die. If we're trying to solve a problem with a series of steps, we want that problem to be solved before we're 6 feet under the ground. In other words, to create useful algorithms, we're going to focus on writing a finite number of steps. The algorithm should have a clear starting point, a step-by-step procedure that we run through, and a clear ending point at which the program terminates. The hope is that when we end our program, we've solved our desired problem. The next feature we're going to focus on is writing our algorithm in simple English. I don't mean that the steps themselves have to be simple. Very often when we're developing mathematical algorithms, the individual steps will be quite sophisticated, represent deep mathematical, logical, or computer science-based thinking. What I mean is when we write it, we're using plain English, not syntax of a particular programming language. Compare the algorithm on the top of our screen to the corresponding statement of that algorithm in MATLAB code. The algorithm is written in simple English using mathematical notation, and the syntax implements that using specific lines of code in MATLAB. Our goal is to write code that even novice programmers can understand. In other words, as we write the steps to our algorithms, we want to avoid using syntax and instead put the ideas in simple English that are easily understood without reference to a particular programming language. This will allow us to take the ideas behind an algorithm and implement them in various programming languages depending on what our desires are. The third feature of good algorithms that we're going to use is creating structures that are easy to modify. Computer programming is an iterative process. Another way to say that is, oftentimes when solving problems, we do it in steps. We solve a subproblem, make it a little bit more difficult, add nuance, solve a related subproblem, and then do this in a chain until we solve our larger problem. Because this often flows over a number of days, weeks, or even months, it can be super useful to create statements of algorithms that allow us to modify, either add new steps, edit and change steps, or even delete previous steps if we feel they're no longer necessary. In any case, as we write our algorithms in simple English, we want to do so using easily modifiable structures. The last thing that we're going to target is clearly identifying the output that we produce in each algorithm. Remember, the idea of coding is we start with a problem, we take inputs in associated with that problem, we do some data processing, we actually change the value of the input in very strategic ways, and then eventually we get to the place where we have a desired output. When we're writing our algorithms, we clearly want to identify where that output is produced and how the code that we've written relates to that output. In the case of a quadratic equation, notice that in steps 2 and 4, we have our desired outputs, where steps 3 and 5 verify that those outputs solve the original problem that we are trying to solve. Quick recap, when we're trying to write a useful algorithm, we want 4 major features. First, we want to do so in a finite number of steps. Second, we want to write it in plain English so that it's easily understandable without reference to specific syntax. Third, we want to write it in such a way that it's easy to modify. And fourth, we want to identify the outputs produced and how those relate to the input given the code that we've written. This is kind of a high-level discussion of how we're going to write algorithms. We're going to get a ton of practice with this as we solve problems using MATLAB. Let's get moving to do just that.